lessons. In this session, I'm going to teach you about the concept combination of resistors. So, in a circuit, all we see each and every load as a resistor. It means all the loads resist the flow of current, and each and every load or a material has its own resistance. Okay, each and every material has its own resistance. So if the materials are connected either in a series way or in a parallel way, what will be the equivalent resistance? It means how the materials are connected. For example, you consider this is a material and this is another material. Okay, this is material A and this is material B. So this is the head of the material and this is tail of the material. Okay, then I am connecting in this manner. If I am connecting in this manner, this is called a series. That is, a tail of one material is connected to the head of another material. Okay, this is head, this is tail, and this is head, this is tail, and tail of the material, one material, is connected to head of another material. This is a series arrangement. Okay, then this head and this head, if these two materials are connected in this manner, okay, that is, these two heads are connected and two tails are connected, this is called parallel arrangement, parallel connection. Okay, so we have a series circuit and a parallel circuit. Now I will start with a series connection. So we consider, initially for better understanding, I will start with two resistors. So these two resistors, let this be R1 and this to be R2. R1 and R2. Okay. Here I have dot here. Okay. So now I am applying a voltage between these two points. So two resistors I have, I am applying a voltage between these two points of a resistor. Okay. So let us see what happens. When I apply a voltage, an EMF will be produced and a current will be flowing. So I consider a current I is flowing. I consider a current I is flowing from this point to this point. I will name the point from point A to B. So two points A to B, and between these two points I have resistors R1 and R2, and the head and tail. The tail of resistor R1 is connected to head of resistor R2. So this is in series connection. As if its very best example is, we are connecting two pipes in series. The same water flows in the pipe 1 and pipe 2. If I am connecting, அதாவது ஒரு ரெண்டு பைப் எடுத்துக்கிறேன், சீரீஸ்ல கனெக்ட் பண்ணிக்கிறேன், ஒரு பைப் ஒரு எண்டில் இன்னொரு பைப் கனெக்ட் பண்றேன். சோ பைப் 1 ல ஃப்ளோ ஆகுற வாட்டர் தான் பைப் 2 லயும் ஃப்ளோ ஆகும். கிளியர்? Same current is flowing here. Also, this current passes through the resistor R1 and it goes to the resistor R2. This is the constraint. We have to apply the Ohm's law. So, what is the, so when a current flows through a resistor, as per the Ohm's law, there is a voltage drop in that resistor. So, now after the voltage, you will not distribute the Ohm. The voltage that I am giving to a circuit will be distributed to the circuits based on their respective resistance values. அதுக்கு என்ன resistance value இருக்கோ அதுக்கு தகுந்த மாதிரி voltage distribute ஆகிறது. I repeat, the voltage given is getting distributed in the resistors based on their resistance values. okay, that voltage is depend upon the voltage drop is depend upon the current and the resistance value. So what is the Ohm's law? Ohm's law says V equal to current times the resistance. V is current times the resistance. Now you see, you apply for resistance 1. So resistance R1. So what is the voltage drop in resistance R1? So V1 equal to, the current flowing through the R1 is I. The resistance is I R. Then resistance R2, the voltage of drop across the resistance R2, that is R2 resistance. R2 resistance R2, that is V2 is I into R2. Okay. So this here the voltage drop across this resistor is I into R1. So that I can write it as I into R1. In this resistor, I times R2. So this is the V1. Okay. So this given voltage is now dropped in R1 and dropped in R2. That is, it is equally, not equally, it is distributed in R1 and R2. So the total voltage V equal to total voltage V equal to V1 plus V2. So please better write it in this sequence. The sequence the right one is the continuator. In the diagram, we have to write it in the book. In the concepts, we have to describe it. There will be a direct for the resistance diagram only. It will be very better, very smart to describe this voltage drop. For voltage drop, it will be described in the monitor. Okay? So, it will be very convenient to understand in future. Oh, this voltage is V1 plus V2 in series. So, what is V1? I into R1 plus I into R2. So then, which is the common factor here? Current. Current into R1 plus R2. So V is I into R1 plus R2. Now I will bring the current to the denominator. So V by I is R1 plus R2. So actually, what is V by I? That is the resistance. So R1 plus R2 is the total resistance. Okay, R1 plus R2 is the equivalent resistance of the circuit. So which is R equivalent. So just pause the video and listen the things that I have written. Continuation path lena pass panite you write the sequence. Okay, so this is the final expression. So R equivalent is the sum of individual resistances. So our series is that if the resistance are connected in series, the final resistance or total are equal. Words everyone else wrong. Equivalent resistance, total resistance. Okay, the net amount of resistance. Okay, so basically the intervals are equal. Total resistance or equivalent resistance. So the equivalent resistance or equivalent, EQ is the equivalent to represent one. The EQ represents R EQ means R EQ represents EQ UI equivalent. R equivalent is sum of R1 and R2. Okay. So it it is applicable for n number of resistors. Rendu resistors are illa 10 irnalum seri 20 irnalum seri 30 it can be applicable to n number of resistors. Okay, so in series circuit, listen carefully student, in a series circuit the total resistance is equal to the sum of all the resistances. You can add all the resistance values in series. Also the current flowing in a series circuit is always same. Ena inga irukadha resistor undna, if we have another three resistors after this R3, R4, and R5, the same current will be flowing. So idha base padi engalukku aptitude question assertion questions la irukku. So the current flowing in a series circuit is same and the voltage is getting dropped in each and every resistor. The current flowing is same and the voltage is getting dropped in each and every resistor. Clear? So please make a note of this. So RN, for N resistors, R equivalent equal to R1 plus R2 plus up to RN. For N resistors, R equivalent is R1 plus R2 plus up to N resistors, RN. Okay. Next one students, parallel combination of resistors. So this is the way the resistors are connected in parallel. That is, this is the head of the resistor R1 and this is the head of the resistor R2. So both the heads are connected and both the tail of the resistors are connected. So if both the heads and both the tails are connected, so that is called parallel combination of resistor. So you see, I am applying a voltage V at this two ends, that is NB, A and B. Clear? I am applying voltage between these two points A and B. The current I is flowing between these two points. Now there is a junction. We call it as a node. Okay? In the electric circuit, we call the junction of the points as a node. So here at this node, the current gets triggered as if the road is going straight. If there is two roads, it is being cut or pipe over there. Pipe in another or junction being formed. In the end pipe will be or junction level or node level. Water now is spilled out. Okay. Here we have அந்த ரெண்டு பைப்புமே இன்னொரு ஜங்ஷன்ல மீட் ஆச்சுன்னா என்ன ஆகும், த டோட்டல் வாட்டர் வில் கெட் ஆடட். தி சேம் மேனர் த கரண்ட் இஸ் ஸ்பிரெட் அஸ் I1 அண்ட் I2. தென் திஸ் I1 இஸ் ஃப்ளோயிங் த்ரூ R1, I2 இஸ் ஃப்ளோயிங் த்ரூ R2. தென் அகைன் த கரண்ட் I1 அண்ட் I2 ஆர் மீட்டிங் இஸ் அட் திஸ் ஜங்ஷன் ஆர் த நோட். கிளியர்? Again both the currents will get sum up and we get a total current as I. So the current I is the sum of the individual currents. This is the starting logic for this concept. So the voltage is same. For the same voltage applied here between here, I am getting the current I and this current is getting splitted as I1 and I2. Yes students? Now, what is I1? I am going to write the equation for I1. So, what is I1? I1 is the voltage across the resistor R1 divided by the resistance R1. That is as per the Ohm's law. Everything is based on the Ohm's law only. எல்லாமே Ohm's law வச்சுதான் எங்க டீச் டீச் பண்றோம். So, ரொம்ப சிம்பிள் தான். So, I1 by the R1 by the voltage of other which is the formula. So, what is across the voltage, parallel combination the voltage same ana irukku. Okay, in parallel combination the voltage is same, because I want to maintain the voltage for all the appliances at the same one. Namma veetla connect panirukra ella domestic appliances me parallel combination la da irukku. Why? Because is our domestic appliances are designed for the voltage of 230 volts. Okay, the voltage rating of the input voltage rating of our domestic appliances is 230 volts. Okay, namma adapter vechi maatradhu vera, but standardized on 230 volt ku enna panirukanga, all the domestic appliances are given as 230 volts. Fan and tube light and drain ellathukume voltage kudukra voltage 230 volts. Current kudra adoda resistance ku thana mari adu eduthukom. Okay, the best example of 230 volt is a tank la irukku thanni varu. Current kudra en theveyana alavu thanni na eduthukuren. So that is analog power. So this 230 volt is the input voltage for our domestic appliances. Okay, similarly அப்ப எல்லாத்துக்குமே பேரலா கனெக்ட் பண்ணா தான் வோல்டேஜ் சேமா இருக்கும். சோ when connected in parallel all the appliances will have a same voltage. Current will be taken based upon the resistance value of that load. எந்த லோடோ அதோட ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் தான் அது கரெக்ட் எடுக்கும். clear? okay now. So you see I1 is V by R1. Then I2 is V by R2. I1 is V by R1. I2 is V by R2. The total current I is I1 plus I2, which is V by R1 plus V by R2. Okay. So now, which is the common thing? So I is V times 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. So this means as per the Ohm's law, I equal to V by R. I equal to V by R. So I is V by R equivalent. So on comparing these two, ஓம்ஸ் லா படி என்னது, வோல்டேஜ் டிவைடட் பை ஆர் ஈக்குவலன்ஸ். ஓகே, ஈக்குவலன்ஸ் ஏன்னா இங்க உங்களுக்கு ரெண்டு ரெசிஸ்டர் இருக்கு. யூ ஹேவ் டூ ரெசிஸ்டர்ஸ். சோ V பை ஆர் ஈக்குவலன்ஸ். சோ தட் இஸ் இது எப்படி எழுதணும்னா, டு நாட் கெட் கன்ஃபியூஸ் ஸ்டூடண்ட்ஸ், ஹவ் ஐ ரோட் திஸ் V into 1 by R ஈக்குவலன்ஸ். யூ கேன் ரைட் திஸ் எக்ஸ்பிரஷன் இன் திஸ் மேனர். ஓகே, சோ this expression V times 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, this is equal to 1 by R equivalent. So I is V into 1 by R equivalent. So 1 by R equivalent is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Clear? So this is the equivalent resistance in parallel. So rendu resistance ku easy ah naenga padikalam, cross multiply panni you can get the final value. So 1 by R equal to what? You have to cross multiply it in R1 R2 plus R1 by R1 R2. Apde inverse, you take the inverse of this on both sides. So R equivalent is R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. So this is for two resistance. This is for two resistance. So which is connected in parallel. Okay. If there is another resistor, you have to separate it. Find. You have to find it separately. Okay. The calculation will be quite tedious. ரொம்ப எக்ஸ்பென்சிவ் பண்ணி. சோ அப்ப என்ன பண்ணுவோம், ரெண்டு இதுக்கு கண்டுபிடிச்சு அதுக்கப்புறம் தேர்ட் ஒன்னோட சேர்த்து யூ ஹேவ் டு ஃபைண்ட். So for example, 1 by R equivalent for 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. If we have three resistors in parallel, this is the formula. First you find values for this, you will get an answer. Then you add it to this 1 by R3. Okay, that is the logic here. So this formula is applicable for n number of resistors in parallel. If we have n number of resistors, then plus 1 by R n. Another mistake everyone will do is, அதை நான் உங்களுக்கு கிளியராக சொல்லிடுறேன். இங்க லெஃப்ட் ஹேண்ட் சைடு 1 பை ஆர் ஈக்குவலன்ட் இருக்கு. ஓகே, அப்ப நீங்க ஆன்சர் எழுதி கால்குலேஷன் பண்ணிட்டு என்ன பண்ணோம், வாட் யூ ஹேவ் டு டூ, ஆன்சர் எழுதும் போது ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் யூ ஆர் கெட்டிங் 1 பை ஆர் ஈக்குவலன்ட். I'll show you an example. If you are getting an answer, listen here. 1 by R equivalent is 5 by 4. இப்படி ஆன்சர் வந்துச்சுன்னா நீங்க ஆர் ஈக்குவலன்ட் போட்டு என்ன பண்ணோம், 5 பை 4 போடக்கூடாது. இதுக்கு இன்வெர்ஸ் எடுக்கணும். You have to take the inverse of this. So R equivalent is reverse of it, 4 by 5. What is the equivalent resistance? You get the equivalent value. 1 by R equivalent is 5 by 4. இதோட முடிச்சுக்கூடாது. நீங்க ஆர் ஈக்குவலன்ட் வேல்யூ ஃபைண்ட் பண்ணனும். You have to find inverse of this. Okay? So please make a note of the students. I will give you time. Video pause பண்ணிட்டு அந்த sequence ல ஒரு எழுதுங்க. Okay? So this is the first one. Very basic equation. Then I am relating the current and voltage using the Ohm's law. And this is the equivalent resistance values. So you pause the video. And right. If you have any doubts, students, please make a note of the doubts in your classroom itself. Next, we will try with some problems based on this. Next one is a series parallel combination. Here I have a resistance R1, R2 and R3. R2 and R3 are connected in parallel and both are connected in series with the combination of R2 and R3 are connected in series with R1. Okay, here we have three resistors R1, R2 and R3. R1, R2 and R3. So R2 and R3 are connected in parallel. So series parallel combination. So what is the equivalent resistance value? So equivalent or equivalent. How to find the equivalent resistance value? Right. So here you leave R1. R1 is in series with this. So first we have to find the current. What is? So the current I is flowing for the applied voltage V. The current is I is flowing. Until this junction or after this node, the current I is going through R1, and after reaching this node, it is heading to 2. Why I have named as I2 and I3 is because based on the resistor name, for your convenience, I have given as. Okay? It is not necessary we always take the I1 and I2. Okay? Since the current is going through R2, I have given the name as I2. And the current is flowing through R3 and given the name as I3. Okay? And it's no wrong that if you do I1, I2 also. So after this point, again the current is getting added. So for first one, voltage OB across R1 is I R1. So this is the parallel combination. What is the equivalent resistance? So the V across. Actually, what is the equivalent resistance for these two? 1 by R equivalent is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Here the resistance are not R1, this is R2 and R3. So I will rewrite it as R2 and R3. The equivalent resistance is R2 and R3. So that is the equivalent resistance value. So R equivalent is, what is the value I will get? R2 plus R3 by R2 R3. So then R equivalent is, R, if we are taking an inverse on both sides, R2 R3 by R2 plus R3. Okay, now so this is the equivalent resistance of these two resistors. Now the voltage applied across this is, so the current I is sitting here. So the total resistance is R1 plus R equivalent. Total resistance is R1 plus R equivalent. So this R equivalent is a combination for parallel. Okay, total resistance R total is R1 plus R equivalent. So you take the combination of total equivalent resistance of two parallel, okay? Then you add it with a series one. Simple way. No need of any confusion. You take the equivalent resistance of parallel first, then you add it with the series. That's all. So this is for parallel. And I will rewrite this circuit. So the same points A, B, I, this is R1, this is R equivalent. The voltage is V. And if you are asked to find what is the voltage drop across these two points, is that is the total voltage minus the drop in this voltage. The voltage across these two points, in case this is C, point C. If you are asked to find the voltage across the point C and B, what is the voltage? It means the total voltage is V. So total voltage VAB is voltage across A and B. That is, VAB is equal to V, that is voltage across R1. VAC plus VCB. Yes? VAC plus VCB. Because we have drop across R1 and drop across this equivalent resistance. Okay, or I can represent this C here. Here there is a drop of the voltage, here there is a drop of the voltage. Yeah. So now VAB is VAC plus VCB. If you want to, if two parameters are given, you can find either of the one. Okay. So if you have to find VCB, VAB minus VAC. formula. The questions, type of questions you will be looking here is, you will be asked to find the current through each resistor separately, provided the total current would have been given or the voltage would have been given. Voltage kuduthuranga, current kuduthuranga, resistance value kekkalam. Idha total current kuduthu individual current kekkalam, voltage kuduthuranga, resistance kuduthuranga. So parameters nadai maari maari kuduthuranga, because what are the parameters you have here is, you have the resistance, current, junction, node voltage, total voltage. Okay, so உங்களுக்கு equivalent resistance இருக்கு. Parameters நிறைய இருக்கு. எல்லாத்தையும் mix பண்ணி என்ன பண்ணலாம், different questions arise பண்ணுவாங்க. You should be very careful that நீங்க junction voltage போய் total voltage consider பண்ணக்கூடாது. Here you should not consider that junction voltage plus total voltage. This plus is the only total voltage. So அதுதான் இந்த formula. Please pause the video and make a note of this. Write down this clearly. Okay students.